Right, so hello and welcome back to Books and Things, and welcome to my TBR video for Jane Austen July. Now, first of all, before we begin, I do have quite a bad cold, so I'm sorry if my voice sounds quite croaky, but if I don't film this today, I'm going to run out of time to do it before July actually starts. So here we go. If you don't know what this is, in the month of July, Marissa from Blatantly Bookish and I are going to be hosting a month-long readathon, which will be called Jane Austen July. There are lots of challenges. I will link the announcement videos from both of us down below in the description. But in today's video, I want to go through the challenges for Jane Austen July and talk about the books that I'm going to be reading for those challenges. I am going to be reading multiple books for all the challenges. I'm basically going to be doing Jane Austen July and nothing else during the month of July. There is in fact only going to be one book that I'm going to read in July which won't be related to this challenge, and that is the next book in the Dance the Music of Time series by Anthony Powell, which I'm currently hosting a very long-term read-along of. So I'll be reading that book, which I think is Casanova's Chinese Restaurant, but apart from that, I will only be reading Jane Austen related things. So let's talk about those books. I have a lot of them. I'm probably not going to get to all of these, but we shall see how it goes. So our first challenge was to just read one of Jane Austen's novels, and there will be at least two of her novels I will be rereading in the month of July, and those are Pride and Prejudice and Persuasion. They're my definite ones. Pride and Prejudice, I'm going to be listening to the audiobook of. Yes, this will be my second reread of Pride and Prejudice this year alone, but I now own a very good audiobook narrated by Rosamund Pike, which is, it's only about 12 hours actually, because Pride and Prejudice isn't actually that long a book, and it's just so enjoyable. So that is a definite listen for the month of July. In fact, I may have already started listening to it because I finished the other audiobook that I've been listening to with only a few days left of June to go, so I thought, well, why not start on Pride and Prejudice? And it is so, so enjoyable. And then Marissa and I are going to be buddy reading Persuasion in the month of July, which I'm really looking forward to. It's been a couple of years since I last read this, and it's one that I really, really enjoy. So I'll definitely be reading Persuasion and Pride and Prejudice in July. The question is whether I pick up any other Jane Austen novels. I'm tempted to reread Mansfield Park, partly because Marissa is reading it at the moment and we've been having lots of chats about it, and I really, really love Mansfield Park. It's my second favourite Jane Austen after Pride and Prejudice. So potentially I might pick up Mansfield Park later in the month or get myself an audiobook of it, but I'm undecided yet. We'll see how it goes, because although obviously I love reading Jane Austen, I'd also quite like to prioritise reading some of the non-fiction and other books I haven't read yet around the subject of Jane Austen. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. The second challenge is to read something by Jane Austen that is not one of her six main novels. So I have three things for this, but they all are quite short. I'm probably going to reread Lady Susan, because that is another of my absolute favourite things by Jane Austen. I'll link my review down below, but it's so fun and it's so witty and it's so sharp. I have it in this little collection here, but Lady Susan is not a massive part of this. It's quite a short novella and it won't take me very long. So yeah, I will probably be picking that up in the month of July. And then I also have these two tiny pieces of Jane Austen Juvenalia. This is The History of England and this is The Beautiful Cassandra. Things that she wrote in her teenage years, neither of which are very long. They're not going to take me very long at all. So the third challenge is to read a non-fiction work about Jane Austen or her time. And I have four choices for this, and I think I'm going to struggle to get to read all of them this month, so we'll see how it goes. My main sort of priority in terms of non-fiction is probably this, which is What Matters in Jane Austen by John Mullen. Its subtitle is 20 Crucial Puzzles Solved, and basically it's ordered in sort of 20 questions about Jane Austen's works and John Mullen kind of looking into them. I hear such great things about John Mullen as an academic and a writer, so yeah, I'm looking forward to this one. I then also have Eavesdropping on Jane Austen's England by Roy and Leslie Adkins. This is more historical than literary criticism, and one that I think should be really, really interesting, but it is a little bit longer and probably a little bit more dense, so I'm not sure whether or not I will manage to get to it this month. I feel like I know so much about the Victorian period and so much about the 19th century from like 1837 onwards, but actually kind of late 18th century, early 19th century, I know a bit about, but not quite as much, so it would be nice to read some history around that time. On a kind of similar note, I have What Jane Austen Ate and Charles Dickens Knew. Fascinating facts of daily life in the 19th century, and obviously this covers the whole of the 19th century, sort of Jane Austen's time and much later, which I do know a bit more about. I think this should be quite interesting. It's kind of lower down on my priority, but on the other hand, I think it'll probably be a slightly lighter and quicker read than Eavesdropping on Jane Austen's England. So we'll see how that goes. And then the other piece of Jane Austen related non-fiction I might try and pick up in the month of July is Jane Austen at Home by Lucy Worsley. I realised I've had this on my Kindle for ages and kind of forgot that it was there. I've only actually read one sort of biography of Jane Austen before, which is Claire Tomlin's biography. So I would quite like to actually read another kind of biography of her. And this one by Lucy Worsley goes through Jane Austen's life, but looking at the places in which she lived, which I think is something I'd find really interesting, especially having lived in Bath and kind of worked at the Jane Austen Centre there and kind of looked at her life in Bath. It'd be interesting to know more about the other homes in her life. Also, I love Lucy Worsley. If you don't know, she presents lots of history documentaries as well, and I think she's wonderful. And also, because Jane Austen at Home, her book, is published by another company within Hachette, which is the company I work for, and Lucy Worsley came, she was like doing a tour with presentations about the book Jane Austen at Home, and she did like a talk to like practice for members of staff at Hachette, and I went along and it just sounded amazing. And she's one of those people, you could just tell how much she loves Jane Austen, so I'm really excited to read Jane Austen at Home for that. The next challenge is to read a modern retelling of a Jane Austen book. Now, I realise I actually have four books for this challenge as well, but I imagine that I will only be getting to three of them. There's one that's a bit lower down on the list. So, one I will definitely be picking up is Bridget Jones's Diary by Helen Fielding. I saw the film years ago and really enjoyed it, and I feel like it's one of those books I ought to read. This is a retelling of Pride and Prejudice. In fact, my four books are all retellings of Pride and Prejudice. I realise that now, but that's fine. I hear good things about Bridget Jones's Diary. I don't think it will take me very long, and hopefully I will get to this month. I took this out of the library and it's due back quite soon, so I think this will be one that I start off the month with, and yeah, hopefully I'll enjoy it. This month I'll also be reading Jonathan Pinnock's Mrs. Darcy vs. Aliens. Jonathan Pinnock is someone I did a creative writing master's with a few years ago. He also has a BookTube channel, so I'll link that down below. And I'm sure this will be great fun. I know that he is a very, very entertaining and funny writer. I will definitely be picking this up this month. In fact, I've already put a bookmark in it, though I haven't started it yet, but it's not very big. It won't take me very long, and it was also my TBR jar pick for the month, conveniently for Jane Austen July. I'm looking forward to this. I think it should be quite fun and a bit different to the other retellings I'll be reading. It's also Longbourn by Joe Baker. This has been sat on my shelves for a while, and to be honest, is probably the retelling of a Jane Austen book or anything that I hear the best things about. And recently I watched Steve Donohue talking about this on his channel in his Classics and Contemporary Pairs tag, which also kind of pushed me to really look forward to reading this. I think it should be quite interesting. It is a Pride and Prejudice retelling like all the rest, but it's set in the same time period and looks at basically the lives of the servants at Longbourn with a few kind of intersections with Pride and Prejudice. I think this should be really interesting, both just kind of as a historical novel as well as a retelling. So yeah, I'm looking forward to this one. Finally, I also have Eligible by Curtis Sittenfield. I've taken this out of the library and it's due back about halfway through July. And to be honest, I feel like I'm unlikely to get to this. If I am able to renew it from the library, I will, and maybe I'll get to it towards the end of the month, but it's certainly lower down my priority. This is a modern retelling of Pride and Prejudice set in the modern day in America, I believe. It's part of a project called The Austen Project, which involves various retellings by different authors of Jane Austen books. I have read the other three that are out so far, The Seven Sensibilities, Emma, and Northanger Abbey. And while I kind of enjoyed, well, two of them, not them all, I didn't enjoy Emma. While I enjoyed Seven Sensibilities and Northanger Abbey, I did have some issues with them, so that's part of the reason why this is slightly lower down on my list. I think if this was shorter, I would probably get to it this month, but because it's quite long as well, and I'm a bit sceptical of it, we'll see. I might get to it towards the end of the month, but the other three are my main priorities for this challenge. Next challenge is to read a book by a contemporary of Jane Austen. One that I'm definitely going to prioritise this month and I'm really looking forward to is Evelina by Frances Burney. I've been meaning to read this for quite a while. I've heard great things about Frances Burney, and I know that she and Mariah Edgeworth were amongst sort of Jane Austen's main influences as writers, and I've read very little from the time of Jane Austen, so I'm really looking forward to this one. I know it's about a young woman called Evelina who moves into London and falls prey to the rakish advances of Sir Clement Willoughby, because apparently Willoughby is just the name for scoundrels. Like, every time I encounter a Willoughby in a 19th century book, always a scoundrel. I'm really looking forward to this. I hear great things about Frances Burney. This is probably my top priority of this challenge. But then second to that, I also would quite like to get to Marriage by Susan Ferrier this month, which I have on Kindle, and I've just heard brilliant things about. Marissa, who's hosting the challenge with me, read it a few months ago, as did Claudia from the Spinster's Library, and Mel from Mal's book Nand Adventures. They all really enjoyed it. I've heard great things about Marriage, and I hear that the main character is a little bit like Lady Susan from Jane Austen's Lady Susan, so I'm looking forward to that. I do also have one other book written down on my list for this TBR, but I'm not sure whether or not I will actually get to it. I would quite like to read some gothic fiction from Jane Austen's time, because I know how much it influenced her in terms of Northanger Abbey and so on. But I was having a look at like all the ones that are on my radar, and they're all really, really long, and I have so many other books I would rather prioritise. But I did download to my Kindle The Castles of Atheling and Dunbine by Anne Radcliffe, which was her first book, which is a novella and not very long, so I might read that. I'll see how much time I end up having, but yeah, that's on the list. So that is my TBR for the month of July. Those are all the books I want to read. Hopefully I'll get to a lot of them. I don't think I will manage to get through all the ones I have mentioned because there are quite a lot. But I am really excited to get to a lot of these, and I know Marissa and I are going to be buddy reading quite a lot of them. So hopefully I will get through a good substantial amount of them and end up having quite a lot of time to read in the month of July. We'll see. Before I go, I do quickly want to talk about challenges 6 and 7, which are screen watching challenges. The sixth challenge is to watch a direct screen adaptation of a Jane Austen book. For this challenge, I'm definitely going to be watching the adaptation of Emma with Gwyneth Paltrow in, because as I think I mentioned in my announcement video, this is the only direct screen adaptation of a Jane Austen book from the last 25 years that I haven't seen. So I'm looking forward to that. And then I'm sure I will end up getting to one in the rest of the month. I'm trying to persuade Nick to read Pride and Prejudice in July and join in with Jane Austen in July. And if he does, maybe we'll watch one of the adaptations of Pride and Prejudice. I really love both, just saying. I know that's not everyone's opinion, but I'm a big fan of both the 1995 and the 2005 adaptations of Pride and Prejudice. I'll talk about that more later on in the month. For the seventh challenge, which is to watch a modernised screen adaptation of a Jane Austen book, I'm hopefully going to rewatch the web series Emma Approved because I love it and I want an excuse to rewatch it. And I might also try and start the web series from Mansfield Would Love, which is an adaptation of Mansfield Park. I don't think if there's any films I will end up watching. I would quite like to see From Prada to Nada, but I'm not sure if I'll be able to get a hold of it. So we'll see how that goes. I do know also me and one of my friends from work, Ellie, who also has a booktube channel called Ellie the Bibliophile, although she hasn't posted for a while, we are hopefully going to have a Jane Austen afternoon one day and watch the Emma with Gwyneth Paltrow and also possibly Emma Approved, because Emma is her favourite Jane Austen book. So hopefully there will be much watching then. I am excited. Those are all the things that I want to read or to watch in the month of July. I am really, really excited for Jane Austen in July. There are so many things that I want to read, and I'm looking forward to all of these books immensely. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. If you want to know what I'm reading or watching during the month, then do follow me on Goodreads and also Instagram. Both of those will be linked down below, and I will be keeping them regularly up to date with all my reading plans. I am super excited to be reading lots about Jane Austen and around Jane Austen, and to be rereading a few Jane Austen books as well. Please let me know down in the comments if you're going to be joining in Jane Austen July, if you are on BookTube as well and have a TBR, or have a TBR anywhere else on a blog or Twitter, Instagram, etc. Please do let me know and leave links down below too, because I would love to find you as well and see what other people are going to be reading for Jane Austen July. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll be back very soon with another bookish video.